Plead my cause, O Lord my God, with them who strive with me. And if it is not possible for them my righteousness to see, then in the conflict that they wage, O Lord, fight thou for me. Take greave and gauntlet, helm and shield, lift up a valiant lance to wield, and barricade the way by which the enemies of my soul approach. To reassure my trembling heart that my salvation thou, Lord, art. But let them be confounded and put to shame who threaten my soul and despise thy great name. Against me without cause traps and snares they devise, seeking ever my hurt as they plot my demise. In thy mercy, O Lord, let their plot come to naught. Turn away in dismay those whom my harm have sought. Yea, like chaff caught in the teeth of a gale, let them be driven off and their evil plans fail. Let thine angels pursue them and put them to flight. Let them stumble through mire in the darkness of night, until in their very own snares they are caught and fall prey to the harm which for me they had sought. Then in thy deliverance my soul shall rejoice, every bone in my body shall find its own voice. For who is like thee, O Lord, the poor to save from the power and dread schemes of those who are depraved? When my fellow man ailed, I humbled my soul and sought with earnest prayer his distress to console. I mourned his adversity as it had been, tragedy befalling my dearest of kin. But when troubles befell me, he gathered my foes to plunder my soul and rejoice in my woes. And false accusations they laid to my charge, their coffers at my expense to enlarge. Savagely they all my substance did tear, and without mercy they nothing did spare. How long, O Lord, wilt thou merely look on? How long wilt thou my salvation delay? Before you rescue my soul from destruction and my precious life from those who would me slay. For then with thanksgiving throughout all the land, I will publish the praise of thy merciful hand. Lord, let not mine enemies gloat over me, nor to the hateful grant thou victory. For though they speak peace, 'tis deceit on their tongue. Against all the peaceable their schemes are laid. They open their mouth to devour from among the land of the living those whom they've betrayed. This thou hast seen, O Lord, silence keep not. Arise thou to judgment, consider my lot. Let not my foes triumph through sin over me, but reap shame and confusion from depravity. And let those who favor my cause then rejoice, with exultant joy let them ever proclaim God's mercy and righteousness with ceaseless voice, and magnify the splendor of his glory.